Hello, I'm Mr. Arnold Jerry, retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Christianity and Sikhism, they are puzzles called parables. And if you understand them, then you are twice born. If you can't understand, then you are once born. There's a parable in Matthew 19 on marriage and divorce, which most people don't understand and hardly known to any. So for the, in that one, you know, the Pharisee Sadducee came to Jesus. They were talking about moral laws and divorce according to moral law. But Jesus interpreted the same thing in spiritual sense and told them, give them the exposition of that marriage and divorce. In spiritual sense, you know, the moral is the one man and woman marrying in open, you know, after marriage they are two people. They were initially two people and after marriage they become two people as well. In the spiritual one is opposite. This one is Jesus described in Matthew 19. For this reason, the man is the soul, which is supernatural. This is natural. Soul is supernatural. You can't see, but you have to perceive with the third eye of logical reasoning, which only the twice born people have. Once born people do not have. That is received by grace of our Father. So, for this reason, the man, soul, which is supernatural, leaves our mother and father, which is God, our parent, God and Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is mother, God is our Father, to join the flesh. Flesh is this one, which is natural. Supernatural joining with the natural. And this marriage takes place in the womb of the woman. You can't see with these two eyes. You can only perceive. So this marriage is performed in the womb of the woman on conception. So they are no more two, but one. It started with two persons, man is soul, supernatural, and flesh is the natural. So when they join together, they are no more two, but one. Whereas in the other one, they are still two after marriage. So there the divorce is possible. And here divorce takes place when you die. And there is divorce also spiritual, which is a different, you know. So Saul, you know, Saul, this is the wife, you know, of our soul, which is inside me. That is the master of this house. So this is the wife, my soul is the man. So if I give my wife to another person to control, and then I have divorced my wife to him, as Saul did to Gamaliel when he became his disciple. So what I mean to say, everyone when he is born in this world, he comes married. He is not single, he is married. Two people, man and flesh, wife, they are joined together, they are married. And if that woman, which is the flesh, you give it to the moral teacher, such as Saul gave it to Gamaliel, then you become his disciple. The root of the word disciple is discipline. So he disciplines you by teaching the moral law of Moses. So Saul had divorced his wife to Gamaliel, and whatever Gamaliel told him, he did it. It was not in his control anymore. Otherwise, he would be a bad disciple. The root of the disciple is discipline, and those, they are once born natural boys between 12 and 16 years old. So Jesus had no disciples, but workers, laborers, twice born laborers and workers. So the Messianic Jews, you know, they have corrupted the Bible, New Testament as well. So you have to be careful. There is no word Lord in our New Testament. Because Lord has slaves, Father has sons. We are the sons of the Most High Father. We are not slaves. So Lord is Yahweh, demiurge God of nature. So when Saul had given his wife to Gamaliel, and he was telling him, go and do this thing, do thing, that thing, his soul just carried on. Otherwise, he will say, this man is not good, you know, not a good disciple. To be a good disciple, he just was giving in to that Gamaliel. In his own heart, he knew what he is doing is wrong. Subconscious, what he is doing is wrong, but he was just obeying the order of the Gamaliel, which his wife was divorced to. So Saul was killing people under the direction of the Gamaliel. But he was devoted, perfect, a disciple. So Jesus took pity on him and came into his way, and then he showed him the real, to become the master of his own destiny, to get freedom from that adulterer, Gamaliel. So at Damascus experience of the lightning, he was blind. After 4 days, he opened his eyes and thick scales came up. Thick scales were the blindness which his wife Saul had been put through by the rabbi Gamaliel. But he has saved his wife now, and he changed the name of his wife from Saul to Paul. So it is same thing, you know, if a woman marries and her husband's surname is Smith, she will be Mrs. Smith. And when she divorces her husband and go and marry another person, say Jones, then her name will change Mrs. Jones. Same woman, different names. So same woman, different name. One was under Gamaliel, and then one was when he became the master of his own destiny. The soul was in his own, this flesh was in his own control. Then he changed the name to Paul. And that is what Thomas said, you know, St. Thomas, unless a female becomes a male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. Unless the female means what Gamaliel was telling Saul, he was doing it. Or your parents, your school teacher, or anybody who tells you, you do it. You are not independent. Then you are adulterer, your wife is divorced, and you are not the master of your own destiny. But when you have Christ in your heart, and you go by your Christ, the inner man, and then you don't follow anyone, blind people follow others, then you are no more blind, you are walking in light. So you need a Christ in your heart, not Christian of the book. Christian of the book have no idea what I'm talking about. So when you have Christ in your heart, then you are master of your own destiny. You don't follow anyone. Then your wife is virgin. Virgin capable of marrying our supernatural father to become his spokeswoman. So let's hear of something written. Well, there is a typical example of Saul divorcing his wife to Gamaliel. And when Jesus helped him at the Damascus Gate experience and on regaining his sight, when he regained his sight, he also had a transformation in his soul. From once born, he became thrice born. Thrice born means twice born. When you are twice born, then you have Holy Spirit with small s. When you are thrice born, you have Holy Spirit with capital S. So here it is, thrice born concept. Once born, twice born, these are twice born. Doubting, seek to serve God. Here you are thrice born. This God lifts you up here. So in that case, you know, Jesus came into his intervening, and then he put him from here to here in the domain of our supernatural Father. And then he became master of his own destiny and changed his name from Saul to Paul. On regaining his sight, and when he had attained the very Spirit of God, he remarried his wife, which was Saul, and gave her a new name, Paul, on the same principle as a divorced woman, say Mrs. X or Mrs. Smith, marries another man, Mr. Jones, and gets a new name, Mrs. Jones. So, new name, XY. So, those who have ears to hear, let them hear. This spiritual mouth, ears are spiritual mouth, and let them hear it. You know, those are capable of. They only dwell in the twice born people. Once born people don't have this ear. What is the, now tell me then, what is the name of man in the marriage, in the marriages of Saul? First he was Saul, and then he became Paul. So what is the name of the man in both of these marriages? Now, this is difficult. because soul you cannot see. Soul is supernatural, you cannot see with two naked eyes. You only perceive. So, soul, you can't give a name because it's not something material that you can see. It is supernatural. Like, this is natural, soul is supernatural. So, nobody can see soul except Father, who had emanated soul, whose son is the soul. So only the Father knows the name of the soul and not the sons. Sons know these worldly names given by the people, and so this is not worldly, this is supernatural. Like you have boundaries, you know, between one country and the other. They are based upon tribal. Countries are tribal lands of the people. So when that tribal land finishes, the other one to start, then you have a boundary. But in God, we do not have a boundary, because we are all sons of the Most High. We are all sons of the God. With different functions or duty to perform. So far we are in accord, we are in accord with each other. We are not fighting or quarreling as those brethren in Egypt were doing. So they remain united. That means there is no snake among them. So I hope this makes sense. And best this gospel is learned through face-to-face discussions. That's why St. Paul stresses in 2 Corinthians 3, that gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but only live it up with our heart. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh, we've done the thing. Oh, good luck.